KPI yang yang buat ada grad tu bahasa, linguistik, it's a master's program. Yes. Engineering, faculty of engineering, two programs, SHE and Biomed. And we have Alam Bina, two programs also. Project management and
ada
dua program lah. Yang ada dalam bilik ni kira yang dah somewhat experience lah, bukan so new lah. Okay, some idea is there already. Okay, so without further ado, kalau Associate Professor Dr. Najwa Hayati, I welcome Associate Professor Dr. Najwa Hayati daripada USIM to help us and guide us and enlighten us on how.
Thank you. ni saya bagi kepada dua bahagian, a bit introduction, okay, and then the topic kedua we will go to component C, okay, and then another objective will be to develop something such as mature course, tapi yang ni kita buat untuk satu topic sajalah, okay. So we will make use of these hours to design and develop the topic. A question that I need to know from all of you: you are going to use LMS, LMS for ODL.UM. Is that your platform?
It's Moodle based, macam section lah.
So yang tu each of you dah ada given account, I mean the course already ready for them to try to upload anything to
this. Okay. Basically, it's the same macam spectrum yang we have been using all this while. Cuma it's another spectrum, but similar. I'm not sure whether individually have you guys have access to the ODL already? Yes, yes.
Okay. So,
dah try belum tu saya tak pasti.
Tak apa, nanti dah try tengok sama-sama. Okay. So, satu lagi questions. Anyone develop MOOC, micro-credential? Dah develop. Pernah ada experience develop micro-credential? MOOC. Tapi saya percayalah, during the PKP, we end up having digital content, kan? Ada experience having digital content, isn't it? Okay? So, I think with that experience during the PKP, it helps you a lot, especially designing or developing the content. So it's not so much about the content. Saya tak akan sentuh banyak berkenaan dengan macam mana nak buat video, macam mana nak menghasilkan content ataupun media yang bagus. Tapi kita fokus kepada scene sahaja. Okay. Boleh tak yang tadi tu? Ada apa-apa lagi that you would like to know about this one? Other than the topics that I mentioned here? Ada? Okay. What is the outcome? Okay, what is the outcome of the learning session? Okay, so I try to apply here. So I put it for topic one, introduction to self-instructional material. At the end of this topic, you will be able to understand the benefit of C, identify the structures and elements of C, and then perhaps you can plan your teaching plan. Okay, prepare your teaching plan for your course. Okay, a little bit about distance education. Previously, distance education or distance learning, we do it physically, by supported by postal service. Lalu dulu kita ada Adabi punya, PJJ, okay, everything post. Okay, so the teaching and learning material, they are prepared very minimal. Okay, so this is the minimal learning tools to address issue of cost and time. So selalunya yang buat pendidikan jarak jauh ni, dia punya isu adalah tak boleh nak pergi ke tempat pengajian tu. Okay, sebab jauh ataupun masalah transportation. Okay, and then some of them dia tak ada masa. Tak boleh nak dedicate proper time to attend the class, maybe also working. Okay, so previously we provide provide this kind of education supported by the postal service. Okay, so kalau dulu memang ada lah hard copy module, tiba-tiba dah sampai melalui pos, lepas tu ada radio cassette tape yang recorded suara, and some of maybe you go up to preparing the video, okay, video tape. Okay, itu masa tu lah, maybe 20 years ago, 40 years ago. But now it's a different situation. We have open distance learning. Okay, ODL. So one of the very well-known institution that offer the ODL is OEM. Okay, so any one of you pernah dengar dia orang punya cara melaksanakan kuliah punya program? Saya I'm not sure. Yang saya tahu dia tak totally online lah. Ada sedikit juga face-to-face punya session, which is to accommodate the needs of the students. Okay. So the dalam concept of open distance learning, it offers effective learning method to overcome the existing barriers. So existing barriers tu adalah termasuk isu pengangkutan, okay, geographical limitations, perhaps maybe juga ada isu berkenaan dengan cost. So by having this open distance learning, we can reduce the cost by everyone attending it online. So they reduce cost basically traveling, tapi ada cost untuk communication tak lah, dengan teknologi punya cost. Okay, so with the use of the latest digital learning technologies, we can overcome all the existing barriers. Okay, open distance learning is also emphasized on self-independent learning and enable students to manage their own learning time. Students can access the learning material in an easy and flexible way at any time, in addition to guidance of instructors and supports of other fellow students. Okay, so make it open using the technology. We are actually offering something that is called as flexible. Okay, a way forward to the fourth IR in our application. So now we already have fifth IR, but talking about the fourth IR is about flexibility. Okay. Open distance learning. Yeah? Open distance learning also using various methods of communication. Previously, communication kita pakai postal service macam tadi saya tunjuklah. Okay. Now we have video conferencing, email, social media, discussion platform as well as various technology combined with face-to-face interactions as well as physical and virtual resources. Previously, we don't have this so much facilities on this room. Okay? Saya ingat sebelum PKP, kita ada Skype. Tapi Cisco, some people are using Cisco Webex. Tapi yang tu semua mahal lah. Kan? Tak semua university ataupun institution can offer that. Okay? But nowadays, we have other options. We can use Zoom, we can use Microsoft Teams. Which is quite common nowadays. Dulu saya selalu cakap, kita e-learning Meta, pergi mesyuarat, tapi mesyuarat fizikal. Why we never do online meeting? I always question that. So we keep on going for physical meeting, but we are talking about e-learning. So why? During that time, which is before 2020, the issues is the infrastructures. Okay, we don't have so infrastructures to support streaming video meeting. But nowadays, alhamdulillah, this is better. Tapi dia punya masalah meeting overlap. Because of this technology, they provide us all this convenience. But at the end, dia jadi disruptive technology. Meetings online overlap, everything doing webinar at the same time, so you don't know which one to do. Okay, then all the LMN will be able to study at their own pace. Yang saya sebut semua ni pernah nampak tak? Have you ever seen all these words? Actually, I ambil daripada ODL UN. Okay, this is from your own. Okay, so just I think I highlight because this is what the aspiration of UM lah. Okay, you would like to offer this. Okay, students able to study at their own pace. Okay, they can with this they can have efficient ideal time management to balance commitment between study, family and career. If you look at data from OUN, most of the students are the people who are working. So I believe that once we offer this open distance learning, our main customer or client will be the part-timers as well. There will be small number, of course, that from fresh from SPM leavers, STPM leavers, but most of it will be from people who are working. Or people who would like, who don't have that opportunity to further their study after SPM, but now they have that opportunity, so they would like to further their studies. Okay. This is the main, these are main features and requirement of ODL. So if you notice, it is outcome based. Thank God that kita memang dah buat outcome based pun, kan? Untuk kita punya undergraduate program, the normal program. So this one kita tak ada masalah lah. ODL expert deal with the challenges of instruction and provide training as well as advice on ODL learning teaching processes and practices. Okay, so ini yang sepatutnya setiap universiti ada lah, ODL expert. Okay, because there will be slightly different challenge when you entertain students yang from the normal program. Okay, you will have a different need. So we need to accommodate the challenges, problems that might have from the ODL expert. Okay. And then the most important one is SIM, self-instructional materials. Okay, very important to ODL. Why? Why do you think this SIM is very important? Anyone would like to share? You are here to develop this. Why is it very important? Kalau tak ada yang ni, can we run the program? Okay. So apa function dia? To replace us. In a way, okay? Yeah, because when you preparing this material so that the student can study on their own, it is more towards the student-learner context, student-learner center. So we are trying to prepare materials so that the student are not depending so much on the instructor or the educator, okay? So ni memang penting lah, okay? And then we should have a platform, and then lecture of interaction, synchronous and asynchronous. So this is the beauty of the technology that we have today. We can have our asynchronous session, even though we are not together in a room. Okay, we can have it virtually. And then we have asynchronous. Okay. I lupa nak cerita. My first job is actually as an assistant lecturer in the so-called, they brand themselves lah, the private university, the first virtual university in Malaysia was UNITA, 1999. Okay, tapi during that time, I memang mengajar online, tapi because of the technology during that time tak evolve lagi, so it's one too many. We are doing online class. Tapi student boleh nampak my slide and can hear my voice. So dia tak boleh nampak I punya streaming activity tak. What more, I cannot see them. So communication is chatting during that. It's already happening in 1999. Masa tu. Dan bekas pelajar saya ni pun dah grad, dah jadi somebody somewhere in the area. Okay, so in a way, it's working lah. Okay, ODL system. Yang ni saya rasa UM dari Iraq. You have support system, support and trainings. You have online platform developed and established. Okay, mode interaction. I think the infrastructure are ready to support us. So this is the one. Self-instructional materials we have to prepare. And one thing that we sometimes terlupa, copyright issue, intellectual properties that we have to protect. Okay. So what is SIM? Okay. Learning materials and conditions arranged so that the student can proceed to learn on their own with little or no supervision. Bila I compare the previous SIM and the current digital content that we have, dalam bentuk MOOC ke ataupun dalam bentuk OCW ataupun open course, OCW open course, ataupun kita kata digital content dalam yang kita buat for our undergraduate students, the normal program, actually it's quite similar. Okay, but one thing that obvious I notice, for every digital content we always forgot about the instruction. Okay, previously, if I may say around 2,000 we have the LMS. Okay, most of the university have LMS, but we dump our teaching resources. Kita letak PowerPoint 1, PowerPoint 2, PowerPoint 3. There's no instruction. Okay, but now I think we learn a lot and come up with guidelines and everything. We already mentioned about sebanyak mana PowerPoint boleh menggantikan sebanyak mana jam kelas. Video yang 10 minit tu is equal to 1 hour. Kita tak boleh nak bagi video 1 jam, 2 jam. Kita kelas kita face to face 2 jam, we prepare the 2 jam kelas, top and top. Okay, no, that's not how we do it in the digital content. Okay, so we have to prepare only the necessary or meaningful content for the students. Okay, self-instructional material play a major role in teaching and learning process at all levels of education and training. Okay, designed to enable learners to study partly or wholly by themselves. Okay, saya kata tadi, jadi dia menggantikan kita. Okay, dalam ODL is obvious, dia akan menggantikan instructor. Tapi kalau dalam konteks normal program yang ada face to face class semua tu, attending class physically, dia tak menggantikan kita. So kita lebih ringan lah. Kita buat digital content pun tak ada instruction, tak apa, sebab kita masuk kelas. Kita masuk kelas, kita bagi tahu dia, nanti you all go through slide yang ni dalam kelas. We can tell the instruction in class. But for the ODL student, there is basically no physical interaction unless you prepare one for synchronous. Okay, so that's why we are actually designing something so that our student able to study on their own or partly on their own. Okay, previously it is a printed SIM, but now we can have digital SIM. Okay, so sebab tu saya kata tadi, siapa yang pernah buat MOOC micro credential, actually you ada hampir experience developing the SIM. Or those, if you already have digital content, actually you already have about 40 to 50% of the SIM. Okay. Okay. Again, what is SIM? Guided. Meaning that a guided ni depend on the instructional and independent activity, self-paced learning, self-individualized learning activities. You prepare mini course and program instruction. Okay. Tutor and lecturers as facilitator, providing motivation and reinforcement. So itu kita punya. After we betul-betul lumus prepare the scene, we can relax and be the motivator. Okay, ataupun facilitator lah. Okay. So sebab tu kalau kita tengok OUM punya program, dia ada facilitator. So if you notice, I dah cakap about few minutes, these are the keywords. Okay, about self. About self, okay? Learner-centered, student partly or wholly themselves, instructions, carry out teacher's function. So how do we come up with this scene? Okay? So basically, we have to put our place in their shoes. Huh? So if we become the learner, what are the things that we need to know? Okay, of course we need to know what we are going to learn. So yang tu yang akan ada objective, learning outcome, and then we also want to know how much time do we need to spend to study this. Okay, for example, topic 1, we can estimate about maybe 2 hours, 3 hours for topic 1. Actually dalam table 4 kita, course outline kan ada kan, course outline kita, if you're using table 4, we state down topik ni berapa jam. Okay, yang face-to-face meeting, lab dia berapa jam, dia punya independent study berapa jam, kan. So, but we never really share with our students. But for this case, we have to tell them at least the times that they need to spend for this topic berapa jam. And then we have to prepare the content accordingly to the time. Okay, ni example of SIM yang telah dibuat oleh Husin lah. Kita pernah ada dan mungkin masih ada ODL
for master by research. So basically, we are actually offering two courses on as open ODL as ODL, which is data analysis and research methods. This is to accommodate students, research students, master and postgrad from overseas. Sometimes they are traveling, they cannot be here, so we have this ODL session. So we prepare the content. At this time, USIM prepare also printed ataupun soft copy dalam bentuk macam ni, PDF, to support the our digital content. Okay. Communication is using the LMS, but this one is for the students to sort of like PowerPoint, tapi kita buat dalam bentuk buku lah. Sama juga, dia ada topik macam biasa, ini macam buku juga lah in a way, tapi dia lebih simple lah dengan. So this is actually the topic, interaction a little bit, learning outcome or learning objective, okay? And then you can prepare something like this. For then, ni adalah bentuk buku. Okay, ni dalam bidang security punya. Atau delat, contoh delat. Kita ada buat pre-activity tajuk. Tajuk, creativity, instruction and interaction, and then the content. Lepas tu, content lagi, then kita buat reflection, enrichment. So, these are keywords lah that you can use. Okay, for your setiap topic. Okay. So, tadi yang saya tunjuk ni semua dalam bentuk hard copy. So, can you imagine how it would be in the digital platform. Okay, so kita mungkin boleh buat ni dalam bentuk video. Okay, penelanan ni dalam bentuk video. Lepas tu kita boleh bagi link untuk enrichment, punya activity. Okay, and then yang ni activity kita boleh prepare pakai web 2.0. Okay, so okay. Okay, benefits of SIM. Yang ni sama lah macam yang saya cerita tadi. Material provided by educator to learners that can be used to carry out all the functions as a teacher would carry out in the conventional teaching and learning environment. We'll be guiding to the open distance learning students for self-directed learning. We'll guide students in terms of providing resources, teaching and learning activities and assessment. Okay. Dalam SIM, kena ada should input proper and good instruction, explaining, asking questions, discussing, monitoring students and progress. So basically, saya rasa essence of SIM adalah good instruction. So that the students feel that they are not alone. Okay? They have the instructor with them, telling them what to do, guiding them, supporting them, motivating. Okay? Even asking during the assessment for them, and also give feedback. Mm-hmm. Give feedback juga. Okay. So for this advantage is this student. Okay. Apart from this, lecturers and instructor pun ada advantage. Okay, let's have a look on the student's advantage. Self-paced, stimulate learning, provide time to reflect and review, continuous feedback, master in specific time frame, learners may skip to more advanced material, cost effective. The good thing about having digital SIM, we can control our learning. Okay, for example, you have a video, you prepare your content in a video. They can always stop and go back to check on the understanding. Okay, tapi kalau dalam kelas, tak ada nak pause lecturer kan? Okay, what? God? By God?
Dia boleh speed up juga.
Ha, ya, dan kalau lecturer tengok, alamak, 10
minit
kan terus lagi. Itu the beauty of digital content. And then when once kita dah buat satu video, kita boleh tambah baik video tu, okay, dengan lebih mudah. Dia tak payah kita kata kita kata kita buat sekali, kita boleh edit dan tambah baik. Okay, walaupun course outline bertukar, okay, saya pernah ada ni lah kita develop satu MOOC course kepada subjek agama lah, subjek agama tu kita ingat subjek apa. Lepas tu after we develop, successful develop, buat rakaman kat luar and everything, this was a good experience. Kita set output pun bagus. Tiba-tiba dia tukar course online, upgrade lah, dia pecah dua, okay? Dia pecah dua. Terus pencara tu rasa, oh tak boleh pakai dah kita punya MOOC, tak boleh pakai dah cerita konten kita nak buat dan kita nak buat rakaman banyak-banyak. Lepas tu, saya tak tahu itu berlaku. Kita jumpa dia balik. Saya tanya, hey, macam mana? How was the apa tu? Feedback from the student? Do they like the cerita konten yang kita dah buat dalam YouTube MOOC and everything? Oh, tak pakai tu. Tak pakai. After 1 year. Kenapa tak pakai? Because online dah tukar. Dia kata, kenapa you tak ambil all the contents that you prepare and make it a different course? Kan sebab dah buat dah. And you can edit and everything. So bila saya cerita-cerita tu, kita panggil lah IT people to help. So they have now 2 course. Digital course. Okay. And then I think friends yang dekat Sunnah, Ibrinas, once they know they love it so much, they prepare the content and everything sebab dia rasa dia buat sekali, kita boleh guna banyak kali for different. Okay, so that's the idea of this lah. Alright, okay, advantages for lectures, macam saya cakap tadi lah. And for the information, creating scene umpama satu publication. Okay, kita boleh ada copyright and, yeah, sebab kita buat. Okay, and then you can consider as publication. In fact, you can write a paper too on the experience of developing the scene. Okay, easy to upgrade to open courseware and MOOC. You can enter exposition and publication as well. More time to do R&D lah. Sebab content kan, kan kecuali kita dapat course baru pula. Itu business story lah. Tapi for student, macam saya cakap tadi, we can pause the video, they can always go back to the content ataupun quiz. Dia buat quiz, jawab-jawab salah, tapi dia boleh repeat balik sampai dia dapat jawapan. Quiz pula given feedback. Sekarang ni kebanyakan kita rushing, tapi saya rasa untuk UO yang kena buat feedback ni lebih proper. Contoh soalan quiz kan, jawapan dia A, B, C. So feedback kita cuma bagi tahu jawapan B yang betul. But actually kita kena bagi tahu kenapa B betul, kenapa A salah, kenapa C salah. That is actually part of the learning for the students as well. So bila we prepare the answer, the choices tu, mesti ada sebab kan? And then kenapa dia pilih tu pun, jawapan salah tu pun mesti ada sebab. So we have to give the feedback to realign the understanding. Sebab kita tak ada kat situ, tak boleh tahu kenapa jawapan A salah, kenapa jawapan B. So the feedback that you prepare for C must be detailed lah, maksudnya explaining. It's not only B, you got it right, no. A, you got it wrong. Okay. The difference between textbook and C. Ini dalam sesi yang sebelum ni, dalam tanya saya. Apa beza textbook and C, okay? So these are the difference lah, very obvious. So I think the obvious is estimated study time, design for specific input of learners, major emphasis on self-assessment. Okay, ini yang paling penting lah. Six characteristics of team: self-explanatory, self-contained, self-directed, self-learning, self-motivating, and self-learning. Tak senang pun.
Nanti bila buat slide lah.
Boleh. Yang sesi saya buat 2021, ini buat tanya. Grup lain. Saya pernah buat 2021 tanya PKP. Saya buat web secara online.
Bila UMC set.
Oh iya ke? A different UMC
set.
Oh, tapi yang ni saya dah update banyak. Yang tu cuma berapa jam saja pagi je. Yang ni pun think selalulah saya buat bengkel. Actually the time needed is to do the things. So I will give you the time to do whatever you have to do. Okay. Alright. Self-recognition of sin, self-esteem, self-wanting, directed learning, motivating, and doing. Okay. Characteristic of sin. Okay, this one. What does it mean by self-esteem? Okay. Students do not need the instructor to understand what is needed to be done. Ini bahasa tu. Straightforward lah. Okay, the instruction and description given to students must be clear. To describe what students need to do based on the materials given, the instruction must be clear to guide students without re-explaining to them on the instructional physically or virtually. Okay, tips, instruction and description must be clear, not ambiguous and direct. Tak perlu panjang, ringkas sahaja. Okay, characteristics of self-contained. Material provided should be sufficient itself to be used for learning and completing any task or assessment. Okay. Instructor must ensure the materials given to students are relevant and appropriate to be used. Students do not need to spend time finding relevant materials on their own unless they wish to know more about the topic that is being discussed. Okay. Point number two. Must ensure materials given to students are relevant and appropriate to be used. This refer to the CMO. Always go back and refer to your CMO. No point for us to sebab dalam digital platform tu kita boleh letak macam-macam tu. So kita pun down the video. That's not how it should go. Okay, letak apa yang relevan untuk mencapai CMO tu sahaja. So sepatutnya scene ni dia ringkas. Satu instruction of volume ni material ni dia ringkas. Dia tak jadi terlalu banyak, terlalu besar. Okay, sebab tu kita ada time. Berapa jam untuk finish that PowerPoint? Berapa jam untuk finish the video? Okay, berapa jam lah? Berapa minit? Okay, sebab masa you should spend for the video, for the student to go through the video. Okay, so must be relevant.
Time
untuk
satu video, the best time ini would be how long?
Dia ada guidance. Saya rasa UM pun ada guidance untuk preparing this media. Kalau di using 10 minutes is equal to 1 hour.
10 minutes
video is equal to 1 hour physical session.
That means what content that we decided to include to one is really, really important.
Really important. And then dalam video yang kita buat tu, lepas tu kalau kita tengok YouTube kan, dia tulis minit satu apa, minit apa. Ataupun dia akan bagi ringkasnya, this video we should provide this information. This video is about what? Please focus on minute. You should focus more on minute berapa for apa? Contohnya for different type of something. Minute 10, minute 5 for the benefits of something. So it's the highlight, the essence of
it. Is it advisable to direct the learner to a certain YouTube video that well established and explain a better way?
Yes, boleh. I will come to that example later. So, preparing the media ataupun the material tak semestinya kita sendiri buat, especially the video and so on. Sometimes we can we are better explaining dalam PowerPoint atau dalam text, but we cannot offer video yang bagus. So maybe you take that video from another provider is good, then kita boleh letak, and then kita kena ni lah, letak sumber dia lah, acknowledge dia dari mana.
Possible
for us to take other people's work, cara untuk kita address menggunakan, kita boleh menggunakan konten orang lain. Sebab itu tujuan dia. Tujuan dia to share so people can use. But we have to also acknowledge the sources ataupun kita kata the economy rights. Sebab everything yang produce as copyright, jadi ada economy and moral right, hak kepada author. So bila the most that we can do is we can acknowledge them. Contoh tertulis, contoh this is from siapa. So people yang baca always can go back to the original and then at least they know that this is original. Dan yang provide pun dia tahu, okay, orang ni tak copy kita punya, dia letak nama kita. Kan? Okay, students are not instructed to find materials on their own, but it is highly suggested to instruct students to find other materials that can be used to enhance their research. So, dalam scene kita tak boleh cakap, okay, sila cari video berkenaan dengan ni di YouTube dan buat report. Tak boleh macam tu. Sebab dia pun tak tahu nak buat report besar. Instruction is to terlalu ringkas, tak mengajar apa-apa. Dia cuma belajar cara-cara bahan. Okay? So the best is kita kena provide the material, bagi link, and then they will get the correct one that kita nak dia tengok. Kita kena bagi instruction sampai tahap macam tu. Kita tak boleh bagi tahu, okay, cari apa-apa video berkenaan dengan topik ini daripada YouTube dan buat ringkasan. Tak boleh.
Macam mana kalau kita punya CO tu sendiri ataupun PO sendiri is related to the require the student to have that skill to search for information?
Okay, but we have to boleh, tapi ini dari sebagai activity, bukan material dia lah, bukan main reference dia. Okay, main reference kita kena bagi. Contoh, kalau case yang kita kata dia punya LO untuk dapatkan skill mencari bahan, so kita kena bagi tahu dulu lah macam mana nak cari bahan. Kita prepare lah dulu kan, slide ke, video ke, mencari bahan so on. And then activity dia okay, baru lah kita boleh bagi instruction for the activities. Tapi kalau dalam scene tu kita letak PowerPoint, betul video, carilah mana-mana video. Tak boleh lah, ha? Kita kena bagi specific video that they have to watch. We can list 1, 2. Okay, that one self-contained, eh? Self-contained. So itu yang maksudnya, when we prepare the content, we try to contain the content according and aligned to the CLO, our course learning outcome. Characteristic of scene, self-directed. The materials need to be standalone, okay? Able to capture students' interest, engage in any task assigned with given materials, diversify materials use, and the material do not necessarily be produced by ourselves. But it is advisable that at least one material is created by us. Okay. Ada video yang kita buat. Tak tahulah, polisi UN memang suruh buat semua video sendiri ke?
Kena buat semua sendiri. Tapi untuk ODL, syarat tu tak macam tu. But kita tak ada lah impression student, dia bayar fees tapi belajar daripada Khan Academy. So kita still nak kena ada presence kita dari segi. At least I think lah, my advice is at least record your own introduction video.
Yes.
To state your presence as the lead facilitator of that course. And then when you have other videos from outside, you have that introduction, you put it in context as the one in charge lah. So yang tu kita buat dengan confidential courses, whatever pun kita akan ada satu introduction video yang nampak muka kita, explain welcome dan dan, and then yang lain-lain tu boleh lah.
MOOC development ataupun micro-crash development ni, dia berbagi ini memang dia minta kita buat introduction video. Introduction video tu 2 minit je tak tersayang? Rowing accident to establish macam yang Dr. Asal cakap tadi lah, establish who's the instructor for the course, what are you going to learn and so on. And then cerita pasal video ni is good also you buat kalau ada masa lah, kita buat satu branding setiap slide, setiap background ada reflect the video course and so on, so tu pulang pada masa-masa. Okay, this one, interesting, interactive, reflective, standalone, video, we can prepare video, short articles, case study, infographic, nowadays we have graphic, we can put it up. We can prepare using Canva ke, even PowerPoint pun boleh lah, to prepare infographic, simplify the essence of the topic ke, apa-apa tu boleh come up with that. Tapi kalau tak mampu as a start, tak apa. Kita boleh suruh student buat nanti. Okay? You can give the task. Tapi kita kena provide the necessary information. Okay? Mungkin last task dia tu, okay, as a reflection ataupun activity kepada student, prepare an infographic summarizing of what you have to do. Okay? Kalau kita yang buat sendiri, ini contoh. Contoh untuk self-directed. Topik dia information security standards. Material, okay. So material prepare a YouTube video that self-created. Maksudnya buat sendiri, kita letak dekat YouTube, okay, supaya senang nak access. So kita boleh buat di public ataupun private lah. Okay. 10 minutes only about my access. Okay, then we also provide for this topic, okay, a short article, 4 pages from Mampu Guideline. A case study that start from based on a scenario, a short webinar video, 20 minutes from NRC for global students. Idea given must be understandable and sufficient to provide information to students to understand the topic. Okay, katalah ni material yang saya dapat. Okay, instruction. You are given for, apa yang kita kena tulis? Bukan letak ni saja. We have to provide this instruction. You are given 4 materials that guide your learning. For example, please do the following tasks. First one, watch the video, YouTube, and I said 40 minutes. To guide you while watching the videos, please pay extra attention to this key concept. Yang ni kita nak sebenarnya. So you have to highlight this to them. Okay? Or you can also be detailed, you can mention which minutes dalam which video that highlight this, ataupun just mention like this. Okay, so this one for the videos. Okay, and then instructions for download and read a short article about ISS provider. This one suggested time 30 minutes. So dia sebab allocate dia, kenapa kita letak 30 minit? Sebab kita nak set your mind it's only 30 minutes. You can finish this. Okay. So, kalau dia baca benda tu tengok, dah sejam. So, dia akan tahu dia sebenarnya tak membaca ataupun dia buat benda lain. Okay? So, this help them to guide them to make it, to motivate them. The article should be easy to read and so on. So, only the things. Okay. To guide you in reading of the article, think about the following questions. Okay? What are the objectives? What are the relevant issues related to apa-apa lah? And then you may add more questions to that. So kita try to instill them what we should be looking for. Okay, number 3, instruction lagi. Read the case given. To guide you in your understanding of the case, think about the following questions. Okay? So, bila ada instruction macam ni, student akan rasa when they read, they know what they're looking for. Okay. Dia rasa macam guided lah. Okay. Kalau kita dapat article lah, macam kita lecturer, we find an article with some intention what to do with the article, isn't it? But for our student, when they were given the article, they actually ada satu basic knowledge je lah. Saya nak belajar pasal topik ni, so lecturer kata baca ni. Tapi saya sebenarnya tak tahu apa yang saya nak tahu.
Kita provide these instructions kan,
faham topik 3.2 kalau kita tak baca 3.1. Okay? So kalau kita confirm macam tu, then kita buatlah setting segitu. Tapi saya rasa tak ada masalah kalau kita set pun. Sebab dia will quickly, dia buka kan, dia tengok. Ini dah tahu dah, so dia will quickly finish it. Okay? So dia can jump to do it.
Saya rasa kalau Dr. Yasin suggest tu dia melawan nature flexible learning. Tak dia terlalu jadi macam
restricted lah.
So ada pula dia suka tengok-tengok-tengok macam kita buat apa-apa yang application kamu kan. Kalau kita buat separuh, pergi next, buat separuh. Tapi kalau application kita pergi next tu, kena siap dulu macam So dia macam melawan kita lah, nak jadi flexible tu lah saya rasa.
Saya rasa terpulang sebab itu tadi kita akan buat macam apa keperluan mapping kepada training box. Okay? So nanti you akan tengok kalau ada situasi yang memerlukan they have to go through and understand this part first, kita boleh pick. Dan dalam kita punya model, not necessarily kita pick semua, kita boleh pilih yang mana kita betul-betul nak dia go through, mesti ataupun ada yang lain mungkin kalau dia tengok tak boleh. Setting yang macam tu sebenarnya dia ada fun tak sebenarnya? Dia ada fun, ada yang tak ada fun. Part tu, ada setengah studio dia kata dia nak tengok dulu semua. Kan? Ada tengok satu ni, sikit ni aku kan? So only this, without ever realizing that you have to finish the topic one, then you will see topic two. Tapi, that kind of instruction, information must be given earlier. Masa kita punya overview course tu, kita boleh masukkan. Kita bagi tahu, okay, this course, we have 7 topics, but first topic will appear first, then the rest will frequently appear after you complete all the tasks in the course. So, ada kita bagi tahu macam tu tak? Okay? So, again, the structure is very important. Okay? Okay, so another characteristic of SIM, self-learning. Assessment, okay? Formative assessment, so clear
markah. Markah tu tak dikira dalam pasal result. Markah tu untuk menunjukkan dia punya performance and understanding. And then we have to keep the feedback. Okay. Okay. Characteristic of SIM is self-motivating. Okay. Students are expected to be internally motivated in their learning via SIM. So how to do this? Macam mana nak buat? Boleh bagi idea lah. Tadi kita dah ada instructions kan? Macam mana kita nak motivate them? Any idea? I letak di sini kan, encouraging words, okay lah, bravo, well done. Okay, you have completed topic one. Okay, once you reach this section, you already completed half of the topic, for example. Okay, well done. Ataupun kita boleh buat compassion questions. Okay, I'll tell about compassion questions later. So, any idea on how to motivate other than what I shared? Basically, our instruction ini dia akan cover all this, cognitive, affective, and
keluar. Macam ungraded system ni. Ada tu sikap yang dia dia skip dia tak buat. Atau boleh kita control kita kompas dia pada tu. Itu kalau buat assessment untuk ungraded.
Alright, thank you doctor for the questions. Actually dalam muda kita boleh set. Kita boleh set that everyone must answer that quiz. Ataupun tak perlu answer dia boleh skip. So again, designing the muda tu nanti Razak kena ni lah. Ada team kan, ada daripada UM punya team yang boleh bantu dari segi teknikal ya. Kita buat satu training lah macam mana nak setting tu. Macam mana kita nak set apa yang kita perlu. Maksudnya kita design our course yang mana part mana yang kita rasa all student must do that task, must go through that task, okay? Mana yang tak perlu. Macam soalan doktor tadi, kalau untuk quiz tu kalau kita kata student kena ambil, kena buat semua quiz kita buat. So kita set dia must dia punya dalam setting, dalam platform tu must do that. Kalau kita tak, sebab dalam kita punya muda setting dia ada kan complete, dia ada progress, sebenarnya ada block boleh mak buat dalam kita punya setting saya ini sudah complete ke tak. So each of the student dia akan nampak dah ada progress dah 4 minggu ke 8 progress baru 20%. Mungkin dia tak buat benda yang kira-kira itu setting technical. Yes, we can do that. Process and model. Okay, ini saya cerita sedikit lah. Dalam design scene and instructional design, kita ada model-model yang digunakan. Yang biasa kita dengar adalah ADDIE. ADDIE is the one that you we use to develop courseware and so on. But this one, surely pun ada. Very related to technique. Provide procedural guide for planning, develop and deliver instruction that integrate media into teaching and learning process. So yang ni lah, analyze learner, state standards and objective, select strategies, technology, media and material, utilize technology, media and material, require learning participation, and evaluate and revise. So you can use this model when you want to design your business. Okay, I mean very straightforward. Image, media, master, and downstairs. So I think since we kita semua tahu course kita apa, so kita tahu potential learners kita kan, mesti background apa and so on tu kita dah tahu lah sedikit-sedikit. So kita boleh tahu lah what we should prepare, right? Then the course outline being given to us, we also know what are the objective, what are the standards, the strategy, then we can plan on the strategies, technology, media and material and so on. Okay, ni ADDIE model. Would like to use this model also, can you can analyze, okay? Sama je sebenarnya, boleh. Design, develop, implement, and evaluate, okay? Usually, ADDIE model we use to develop a courseware. Kita guna yang tu, tapi guna method pun boleh, Azure pun boleh. So, at least kalau orang tanya, how do you develop a scene? So, you can see that I'm using ADDIE model or Azure model. Sedap sikit dengar aku pergi teori yang dia beri
sama. Cuma cerita sikit tak ada kenal buat piece ni teori.
Okay. Asya model ni dia kalau
sebab dengan ini sasi tau dari teori yang sedap sebelumnya ada.
Oh ni. Yang
ni. Ini sasi teori.
Sasi teori. Okay.
Atau sikit dia punya sendiri.
Basically the instructional theory is ni dalam teaching and learning. Basically, instructional theory is about how you give your instruction, how do we deliver the learning, the teaching and learning. So basically, begitu. Kalau we do, kita banyak on how do we say things in class. Maksudnya limited, kita punya alat bantuan mengajar pun dia very limited. Tapi dengan sekarang ni, kita boleh lebih express our instructional dengan ada support
social media dan lain. Tapi giving the instruction is very important sebab dia akan menunjukkan keperluan kognitif, efektif ataupun satu. Contohlah kalau psikomotor, ada subjek yang melibatkan psikomotor, so you have to give instruction yang melibatkan perbuatan.
So, kalau kita pergi dekat source tu ada detail
sangat. Ada, ada. Sebab dia panjang sangat, so saya tak nak letak sekat kat sini. Okay, this is the one that ni nine event instruction. Ini ada yang yang very close relation with the Azure model. But you can use Arduino, kita boleh pakai juga. Ya. So, yang ni biasa, dengan motivate learners, inform learners of the objective, direct attention, stimulate recalls of prerequisite materials, provide guidance for learning, enhance retention, elicit the performance, assess the performance, and provide feedback, promote transfer of learning. That we should use 9 events of instruction. Ini dicatatkan dan disuruh guna dalam SIM lah, dalam content, digital content. But without we realize, kita masa kelas tu kita buat kan? But we don't even notice it. I mengajar beberapa tahun, tak perasan pun. Tapi bila tengok kat ni 9 event instruction, when you want to develop mood, what we did in class. Assalamualaikum, good morning everyone, how are you? You still remember the class that we had last week? So today we are going to, these are the things that we are doing. Tapi bila kita guna LMS, kita dump je PowerPoint. Letak je PowerPoint, topik 1, topik 2, topik 3, artikel, PDF and so on. No instruction given. So kita frust, kenapa student tak masuk-masuk, kita guna LMS. Masuk keluar lagi, 2 minit. Okay, so that's the thing. For example, get attention. Masuk-masuk, hey you, tak ada lagi. Assalamualaikum, apa khabar? Selamat, apa-apa? Inform learners of objective. Okay, so today we are going to learn about what okay, so the objective, the aim is what. So, okay? So we are going to spend plus 2 jam. Kalau plus biasa lah, kalau 2 jam. So, kita pun inform learner objective and so on. Dah 10 minit. Or cerita balik apa yang sebelum ni. Okay, sebelum so record of prior information yesterday or last night, the news and so on. Then kita buat apa macam tu. Okay, present information. This is a demonstration of work. Then provide guidance. This is guide for performing. Okay, LC performance, now you learn. Okay, and then provide feedback, what you need to do and so on. Kalau dia dah buat, tengok, okay, kenapa dia tak jadi. Contoh pelajar buat coding, run tak dapat. So kita pun tengok, okay. And then we provide the feedback to what you have, you, what you are missing and so on. Assess performance, we will now have a performance test. Okay, ataupun simple performance, simple understanding checking lah before we end the class. Then we will now click on the enhanced retention and transfer. So, yang ni yang selalu kita jarang buat. So this is the best thing, giving the instruction in the class, complete 9 different instructions in one session. Knowledge tu mungkin akan berbeza. So kita kalau kita dengar, kalau kita suruh dia orang tulis 100 orang tu dan kita buat analisis, kita akan dapat tema yang lebih kurang sama. So we can ask them and maybe 10 of them give the feedback, then kita akan respond. Okay, so that's how they will learn from the feedback. Alright, so what should I prepare? Okay, objective and purpose of my subject, intent of every topic, direction of the study, prerequisite skills, alignment, complete the subject and assignment, resources and learning activities, self-assessment activities, relevant to test and process.
Kalau boleh pula.
Ini lagi objektif, kena use. Ini contoh lah, yang ni yang saya punya dulu sebelum kita banyak facility of technology. So I put it as a learning outcome, topic summary, what are the activities, self-check, mind map, exercise summary. Tapi kita boleh susun dalam bentuk lain juga ni, sebagai contoh. Okay, how do I start? Okay, you already know your course. Ada members ke? Tu seorang dia.
Ada yang.
Ada group, ada yang tak ada, tak ada masalah. So sebab subject matter expert adalah kita, so kita yang boleh design. So I letak dia dua phase, writing module and enhance media development. Or not necessarily macam ni, kita boleh kita buat dulu mapping plan kita. Okay? Okay, a little bit before we do our activity, I want to talk about intellectual properties. Okay. All six tablet are governed by the general intellectual property policy of the university. So saya rasa UM ada intellectual property. Okay. Text and media, so you can have the right to claim whatever you produce on your own, that is yours. Okay. Or we can, kita boleh guna dua method, sama ada using the copyright, or you can use the Creative Commons, CC BY NC SA. Okay. It is suggested to classify completed e-learning module, 100% original work, or any e-learning materials with no use of external media as the volume. Okay. But we also have another option for to use external media, kita letak benda di CC. Kalau kita menggunakan produk luar yang ada yang ada
Creative Commons,
so yang kita boleh
guna. Is from the reference textbook. Kita itu
harus
publishing
dengan dia. It's from the textbook, but did you do anything different? Kalau property yang make that. Tapi I do not understand, when we talk about intellectual properties, especially dalam bentuk ideas, copyright, everyone can have an idea. Okay, so how do you express the idea? Contoh, yang paling mudah, kita buat lagu, create a song. Memang lagu cinta, tapi hasil berbeza. Okay. So each of us boleh ada copyright for that lagu. Sebab tema sama, tetapi how do we express it differently? So your answer, if we want to use, we are referring textbook, because textbook provide all the information related to our model. But we use our own words and place a little bit, we add some pictures to make it more understandable, and then it's come out the level to all.
Even after we rephrase that idea, it is still required to reference.
Kalau kita betul-betul memang kita punya sendiri, dan it's solely ours, kita boleh tak. Kita ada contoh, kita ambil gambar. Kita ambil gambar awal. Semua orang ambil gambar awal. Tapi sebab kita yang ambil gambar tu memang kita sahaja, so that is ours. Walaupun benda yang sama. 24 minit. Pergi dekat website dia. Ataupun kalau kita ada gambar, kita letak watermark. Pokiran dan pokiran. Kalau yang macam ni, boleh juga ada watermark. Kita letak watermark dan orang tahu. Macam yang saya tak contoh dalam setengah slide. Ada logo C, 20 logo C kan, ada orang lain. So, tak ada juga. So, isu about intellectual properties ni, kita kena maximize self-developed material. Okay? And then minimize external media usage. So, please refer to university guidelines and so on for the particular. Okay, ni adalah yang sekarang ni, I recommend you all buat bisnesnya. Structure, online of the scene, cost description, cost objective, selection of content, creation of content, creating interactive activity, creating interactive content, assessment, reference. Okay, make sure align. Interesting and open. Okay, so kita go through dulu. Then, okay, this one is about structure or outline of the scene. So everyone know your cost? Cost outline dah ada? Cost outline? Topik dah ada?
So,
buku pun ada. CRO ada. Konflik ada. So, you pecah lagi kepada model. Okay. Modul 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Dalam setiap modul ni, ataupun setiap kalau tak ada modul, copy it. You kena ada introduction, duration, modul apa. So, maksudnya kita ada CRO, PLO. Then kita design ke. Dalam cost kita, kita assume this is other cost. We have cost interaction at the beginning, ataupun cost overview. Okay, then at the end, kita ada cost summary. Tapi dalam setiap topik ni, dia akan ada dia content sendiri lah, interaction sendiri, instruction sendiri, module, outcome, so on. Okay, ini yang saya nak you all try buat dulu lah. Dah ada the planning. Everyone already have the plan on what to do for your topic, for your course. Okay. For example, title, apa, module learning outcome, evaluation. So, why do we have to include module learning outcome? The topic and outcome. Why do we have to explain it? The content. Is it what? So, kita tengoklah kita punya CLO ada berapa. Kalau siap-siap CLO kat SRT, kita 20 jam, kita ada 10 modul. Dan kita nak bagi dalam berapa. Tapi tak semestinya 10 modul 12 jam each. Kita tengok weightage of the weight, of the module and the content. If that module need to really to have more longer student learning time, then kita spend banyak. No issue on diet and non-diet SRT because SIN is totally non-diet. So, I'm not sure you already there were outline to which one. So, kalau... itulah. So, saya punya plan tadi tu nak pukul 11 kan. So, kita break dulu. Nanti lepas habis makan, boleh ambil masa lah untuk buat yang so, saya allocate dalam 30 minit boleh? Untuk.
Kita cuba.
Cuba buat. Okay. Okay, kita break.